place that makes you smile. Stick around and stay a while. We're the home of great TV. That's memorable. That's me.
Follow me, sir.
Call them classics, call them the best. Call them favorites, be a guest. Every day there's more to come. Watch and see, there's only one. Me TV.
All you have to do is watch me.
Are you kidding me?
Follow me.
That's memorable. That's me.
That's me.
Me, me, me. Me TV.
It means the first refrigerator. It means a history of innovations that help make your home life better. And now we introduce the new Frigidaire French Door Refrigerator with over 100 ways to organize for maximum flexibility. Built with adjustable flip-up and slide-under shelving and stackable crisper drawers, it's the refrigerator that flexes to fit it all, no matter what your day will bring. Frigidaire, over 90 years of legendary innovation.
See the full line of Frigidaire appliances at Ventura TV Electronics and Appliances.
Hi, I'm John Malos. Welcome to this live edition of Connect with Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this day. Glad you're with us today. We're talking about Colin Kaepernick and his refusal to stand during the national anthem. He did it again last night. You can call in at 436-ME-TV option 11. When you get the voicemail, hit option 11. We'll also talk about habitual liars. Do you know one or two or three? Call in back in just a moment. Back here on the program, the Friday before Labor Day, of course, 2016. It's Connect with Me on MeTV Fresno, Comcast Channel 375. And if you're over the air broadcast with those one of those antennas, those digital antennas, it's 13.1 and 43.6. Quick programming note, I will be here live on Monday morning. Yes, it will be Labor Day. Doug Vagum is going to be here to talk politics and that water situation out there in Northeast Fresno. And what does it all mean that all these people are endorsing these candidates? So the mayor endorsed Lee Brand yesterday. Okay, is it going to make a difference when you go to the polls? Will you be thinking about that or others who have endorsed candidates? Maybe, maybe not. We'll talk to Doug about that during that time. Anyway, today's program is the focus, at least for part of this program, will be on Colin Kaepernick. He's the quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers. He started last night against San Diego, and it was military night at Qualcomm Stadium. And so, as you know, San Diego is a big, huge, massive military town. So they honored the military last night. Colin Kaepernick did not sit down during the national anthem. He took a knee. One of his teammates, also in support, knelt down with Kaepernick to show his support for his teammate. And there was one other player up in Seattle, Seattle Seahawks playing the Oakland Raiders at the Coliseum. One player actually sat during the national anthem to show his support for Kaepernick as well. Colin Kaepernick held a long news conference after last night's game, but here is what happened during the national anthem as Colin Kaepernick, for the fourth consecutive game, did not stand during the anthem. He's taking a lot of heat around the country. Here's what it looked like last night.
What so proudly we'd hailed at the twilight last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars.
Or the land, hand of the free.
Petty Officer
200,
class,
240 servicemen were holding that flag almost the length of the field, and Colin Kaepernick was on one knee surrounded by several teammates. I did not.
All right, live in our studio now is Peter Nazaridian. He's our resident therapist. He's here to talk about the effects of Colin Kaepernick's not standing for the anthem, of course, last night and all the other games. He took one knee last night along with one of his teammates, that person showing support for Colin Kaepernick. By the way, let's put up a photo of Colin Kaepernick just for a moment before we go to break. Colin Kaepernick, of course, playing in the NFL now, his fifth season. He went to the Super Bowl 3 years ago, was 7 yards away from actually winning the Super Bowl for his team against the Baltimore Ravens. It didn't work out. It was Harbaugh versus Harbaugh in that game. Remember that? At the Superdome in New Orleans. So since then, his career has gone downhill. He had a terrible game last night. Colin Kaepernick having his struggles on the field, but certainly he volunteered in his news conference last night, said he will volunteer his time and he will give away $1 million of his salary to support any of those groups that are in support of the racial injustices that are taking place around the country against people of color. That is his main protest against what is happening around the country. He says he's not disrespecting the flag. He is not disrespecting this country. He is not disrespecting the military. But he is outraged at the disrespect and the injustices against people of color, specifically police, the way they have handled some of these police shootings around the country, including right here in Fresno. You know, Dylan Noble and the story there with the lawsuit happening and many other lawsuits to follow. 436 MeTV, option 11. We're back with our program here on Connect With Me on this Friday morning.
Sports is now on KBHF 4.3.
You can find movies on over-the-air channel 13.3. Movies. Our name says it all.
Back here on the program, and so Colin Kaepernick creating a lot of controversy around the country, and as you know, he took a knee last night along with one of his teammates, a player up in Seattle, took the bench. He actually sat down during the anthem at the Oakland Coliseum against the Oakland Raiders, but Peter Nazaridian is here. We do have a phone call waiting. I'm going to ask that caller to hold for a moment. In your mind, is this hurting him in any way, and what kind of a message do you think he's sending to the rest of the country?
Well, thank you, John. I appreciate it, and hello, everybody. I think it must be very distracting. In fact, I asked John just before we took this, we came back on the air, do you think this is distracting the team? And John's got an old sports background and goes back a long time. Yeah. What's happening to him? I think he's becoming a lightning rod for a lot of the anger, the frustration, the incredulity of the people around, and not sure what to do. I wonder his teammates. Some might have been in support. You mentioned somebody else took a knee or sat in a bench, so I understand that. But I wonder how the rest of people say, we just want to focus on the game and win. Why are you doing this? Why, can't you do this some other way? There must be a tremendous amount of resentment in that locker room, and I just wonder how distracting that might be for the team's forward progress.
Yeah, you bring up a good point, and I want to put up the photo of Colin Kaepernick just one more time because the focus is, look, NFL teams, it's a business. The National Football League is a multi-billion-dollar business, if not a trillion-dollar business. Teams are in the business of winning. That's what they pay these players for. He's making anywhere from $12 to $18 million a year. he's there because the 49ers want him to lead that team to the Super Bowl and win. They don't care if he stands for the national anthem. They don't care if he stands for the military or not, or stands with it. They want him to win on the football field. Huge distraction. Go ahead, caller. You're on the air with Peter Nazaridian.
Peter, you know, I'm kind of disgusted in what he did, because he's putting down military, firefighters and police officers, every branch. And what he's doing is hurting the young players coming up, because, well, if he can get away with it, so can we, you know, so they'll have an issue. But at the same time, it's a commissioner's fault for not putting restrictions or suspensions on a player. Maybe he has the right, the First Amendment, whatever, but that does not change the rule just for one person. They make the money, like John says, to win. Now, who are we going to say that he's a good example for my son or daughter, whatever? And then he does that, even with the afro he wears, to be an example. And in my own way, the way I feel, and after I saw it and I heard about it in the media and everything, I go, man, how can a person who's supposed to be a good example for the young people coming up do something like that? If I were that player and I didn't agree to that, I wouldn't even talk to him. You know, he's got to win. That might be a different story. But I'm disgusted that he's done that to the United States has a bad rap already. And he just showed it. He cares less about the United States. So my question to you, Peter, is this. What drives someone like him to do what he did just because he makes money? That's all I want to know.
That's a great question, and I'm not sure that he's doing this because he's making money. He can get away with it right now. He's breaking a precedent. No one's ever done this, as far as I know. I'm sure at some point they did. But the idea of making a national focus of, I'm just not going to stand for the national anthem, and it's not illegal. It's not against the law. It is a suggestion, if you love this country and the national anthem is played, show some respect and stand. Okay, everybody does that. And when somebody doesn't, it's, well, what do we do with that? It's out of sequence. Number two, he's choosing to protest something that has nothing to do with football. You're there to watch a football game, and that should be the focus of it. If he has a protest, there are innumerable ways to protest, by calling your legislator, by making a press conference outside. But at least do what everybody else is doing, so the focus stays in the group. As John was saying, without that focus, you don't win. And you were talking about one notch is all it takes. The difference between winning and losing is just a tiny bit, and that distraction factor is huge. Can he get away with it because he makes money? I don't know that he's getting away with it. I wonder, because he seems to be drawing a lot of heat, and the team's not doing very well. So I don't know how this is working. As far as the example, yeah, I have to agree. There's athletes, even movie stars, are something of a role model, even though maybe they shouldn't be, but they are. They have some responsibility.
Thank you. Go ahead, caller. You're on the air with Peter.
Hey, look, I think we're missing the big picture here. Everybody's calling in, talking about Colin Kaepernick disrespecting the country, disrespecting the flag, et cetera, et cetera. Look, this country was founded on the right to protest, and I do not think, at least he's not out robbing, raping, looting, and burning, pillaging, and plundering, okay? It should have never gotten this far. He's right. We've got rogue cops out there doing roguish things. And if the departments had put these guys in check in the beginning, we probably wouldn't even be discussing this or have this where we are. We wouldn't be where we are now. He's got a right to protest. I think it was Daniel Webster, Henry Clay, who said, hey, I may not agree with what he says, but I'll defend to the death his right to say it.
Yeah. Caller, can I ask you a question?
Sure, go for it.
Yeah. Shouldn't he be doing this outside of the realm of football, though? Because the fact of the matter is, he's there to play football. Why not do this on his own time instead of creating this major distraction within the football organization itself and within the NFL? Because the fine line between winning and losing is so thin. Everybody who's playing at that level, that professional level, has roughly, just roughly speaking, I'm speaking on general terms now, roughly the same talent. Now, there are those that are the upper echelon, the superstars, but what really separates winning from losing is the mental aspect of the game when you hit professional sports. So shouldn't he be doing this on his own time, away from football, away from the 49ers, so it doesn't create this distraction? Because he's not a very good quarterback right now, and the Niners are pretty much a lousy football team.
Look, number one, Colin Kaepernick was never a good quarterback, okay? That's first and foremost.
That's it? That's your answer?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I was watching your lips. I'm sorry. Number one, he wasn't that good of a quarterback in the very beginning. Okay, but if you want to draw attention to this, what better way to do it than to get the masses or the forum? We're all talking about it now. Let me give you a quick example. When the refs went on strike a few years back, the NFL took a hard line up until that Thursday night game where the refs really blew the call. And now everybody was up in arms, and now you get somebody's attention. And now they figure, well, maybe we should do something about this.
I'm just saying that Colin Kaepernick is still a high-profile player because he did go to the Super Bowl one year. He didn't win it. But if he did this outside of football, hold a news conference, say this is what I'm going to do, he would still get attention for it, wouldn't you say?
Do you think it would garner the attention if he did it outside the forum as if he did it where he's doing it now? And now you got millions of people in the country watching instead of, and you really think he'd get the attention if he weren't doing it outside this forum?
So maybe, I don't know, let me pose this question. Thank you, caller. Let me pose this question to Peter. Colin Kaepernick, maybe he has a decision to make. Does he want to be a football player or an activist?
Yeah,
can he be both?
I agree. You make an interesting point. I'll throw a red herring in here. He's not a very good football player right now. We had high hopes for him, but he doesn't look very good. Is this just a way of distracting from that? Oh, the team is losing, not because he's not very good, but because there's all this distraction going on.
Well, the other players aren't that good either, but...
Well, that's what I'm wondering if, in a weird kind of way, is this playing into, here's the reason we're not winning, is not because we're not good, it's because we're so distracted.
Yeah.
I'm not saying they did it as a plan by any means, but you know there is that fringe benefit in some ways.
Yeah, but if the Niners cut him, they'll have to pay him, and there will be other, maybe a handful of teams that will want to pick him up because he still has, I think he's young enough where he still has that potential of being a good quarterback if he's with the right team and the right coach. But go ahead, caller. Go ahead, you're on the air with Peter.
Good morning. I did see the game last night, and I noticed he did sit down again. There's a lot of controversy on the NFL side and the news, but what got my attention, one said it was pertain to superstars. Well, you know, what better gossip is there than Hollywood gossip, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, they said that he changed his mind about standing for the anthem because of his relationship with the lady friend that he has currently, his fiance, and her beliefs.
You know, I don't know. I mean, this is all speculation. I know he's dating a girlfriend who is now she's Muslim, and many are wondering because Colin Kaepernick grew up as a Christian, maybe, and some of the tattoos have Bible verses. That he has on his body, and now he's changing his tune about America, about how he feels. That's all speculation. We don't know that. We're not inside his head. We don't know what's going on. Peter?
Well, as the French say, cherchez la femme.
I don't know what that means, but
look when there's a problem,
sounds great.
Look for the woman.
look for the woman?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they have so much influence. So I'm not saying that she does, the first time I'm hearing this, but... If he's changing his belief system and he's had this relationship
and
in some ways it goes like that, well, then maybe she's having some influence. He wouldn't be the first guy in the world to be influenced by the woman in his life. Goodness knows.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Who's to say?
That's certainly a possibility, but doesn't he have a mind of his own? That's the thing. I don't know. Yeah. The question I have for you,
What kind of a message is he sending to the youth of America? I mean, didn't Muhammad Ali do it the right way?
Well, two questions there. One is, what message is he sending, and what message would we like him to send? In that position, he has some significance. He has some power. He has the ability to affect how people think and feel to some extent. He's a professional athlete. And how is he using that? Very much in a personal agenda. I agree with you. If he wants to take that agenda into the world and give magazine interviews and get on television and press conferences, etc., great, do it. It's still going to be distracting, but at least it's him and everybody can kind of call that's his deal. But when he sits down in the middle of the national anthem, everybody in the team is affected whether they like it or not. I'm not sure that's the message you want to send. I'll do whatever I want. The heck with the rest of you. That's not a good message when we live in society. You've got to play by the rules or everybody hurts.
See, the difference is, I got to take a break here. The difference between what Colin Kaepernick is doing and what Muhammad Ali did is that football is a team sport.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And if you create a distraction and even any kind of animosity within that team, you got a huge problem.
Affects everybody.
It affects everybody. Yep. Boxing is an individual sport, and certainly Ali did not let his anger for what was going on around the country, all of the injustices, affect his ability to box in the ring. It was it's all within him. It's an individual sport.
He made that name change from Cassius Clay to Muhammad Ali, and right. that was kind of controversial, but that was something he did. And eventually we just assumed, we sort of forgot about Cassius Clay. He did it the right way.
Right, but when he went into the ring to box and they played the national anthem, he didn't protest the national anthem.
No.
He protested in other ways.
Yep.
He gave millions of dollars away, as we all know. He traveled the world for injustice, and he created quite a controversy. But still, 436-ME-TV, option 11, if you want to call in. Sorry about that last caller. We had a hard time hearing you. Didn't mean to cut you off, but if you want to call in and call back, if you hear the voicemail, just go ahead and hit option 11. We're back with our program talking about Colin Kaepernick. And in the part of this program, we're going to spend time talking about lying, my friends. It seems to be the wave of the future, and maybe even the present. Back in a moment.
Not sure what you're watching? Want to see what's coming up next? Or just want to browse what's on without the hassle of flipping channels? Your wish has come true. Now you can view schedules for all the digital TV channels available in the Central Valley. Get local weather updates and forecasts, and listen to nationally syndicated Biz Talk Radio, all on KVHF 4.1. Rescan your TV now, then tune in to digital channel 4.1 to start enjoying the all-new TV guide.
The new Frigidaire Professional line at Ventura TV Video Appliance. Enjoy generous-sized cooktops and sauté or simmer with ease, while true convection ovens offer even baking and juicy roasting perfection. Foods stay their freshest in spacious refrigerators with convenient controls and clear filtered ice and water. Easy to clean surfaces reduce fingerprints, and the quietest of dishwashers makes cleanup a snap. The new Frigidaire Professional line at Ventura TV Video Appliance.
Back here in the program talking about Colin Kaepernick, and a few more minutes talking about this, and we'll move on, of course. And, you know, a lot of people have protested this in different ways. And I want you to take a look at this piece that we ran the other day, and it's worth running again. We did talk about this during the program, and it's Colin Kaepernick sitting down during the national anthem. And then you have these people that are out there so outraged, Peter. They're out burning jerseys. Did you see that?
Yep.
They're out burning his jersey.
Yep. I'm sure his personal stuff has taken a hit.
Oh yeah. All the jerseys in the stores and all that. But let's roll that piece right now, and you can take a look at it for yourself.
First, the story that has everyone talking tonight, Colin Kaepernick, defending his decision to sit out the national anthem at Friday's preseason game. Our Maria Medina caught up with the defiant and determined 49ers quarterback at Levi Stadium today.
I'll continue to sit. I'm going to continue to stand with the people that are being oppressed.
49er quarterback Colin Kaepernick is standing his ground about his choice to sit during the national anthem.
This is because I'm seeing things happen to people that don't have a voice, people that don't have a platform to talk and have their voices heard and affect change.
Kaepernick explained in the locker room after practice today, he made his decision based on what he believes are social injustices in our country right now. The example he gave, police brutality, claiming he's been racially profiled by police in the past.
One of my roommates was moving out of a house in college, And because we were the only black people in that neighborhood, the cops got called and all of us had guns drawn on us. You can become a cop in 6 months and don't have to have the same amount of training as a cosmetologist. That's insane. I mean, someone that's holding a curling iron has more education and more training than people that have a gun and are going out on the street to protect us.
The quarterback has actually sat during the national anthem at all the preseason games, but no one noticed until Saturday's game when he did it for the first time in uniform. He says many of his teammates support him.
Everyone has a right to, you know, stand up for what they believe in, so I respect that first and foremost, whether I agree with what he did or not in the way he did it.
Kaepernick says he believes what he's doing is right, even if that means his decision has consequences on his career, including getting cut from the team.
I can't look in the mirror and see other people dying on the street that should have the same opportunities that I've had.
Kaepernick was actually asked to speak to his teammates about why he did what he did. He says they had an open conversation about it. Some of the players told us they understand his decision. At Levi Stadium, Maria Medina, KPIX 5.
Well, reaction on social media has been fiery, to say the least. Fans have been posting videos of themselves burning their Kaepernick jerseys and other merchandise. Thousands are also lashing out on Twitter with comments like this. Hope Blaine Gabbert wins the starting quarterback job for the 49ers. Let Colin Kaepernick sit on the bench just like he did for the national anthem. But many others are standing up for number 7, saying, quote, people are more upset by Colin Kaepernick not standing for the national anthem than they are about the treatment of those he's referring to. Another supporter tweeted, love, support, and respect to Colin Kaepernick for taking a visible stand against intolerable violence in the U.S.
So what do you think, Peter? Is this going to continue?
I think he's got the, certainly has a right to say what he wants to, and he makes a valid point. Is he using the right venue to do it? That's all. You know, why do it at the game? That's your job. You don't go to your job and make a stink. You go to your job and do your job. So love what he's saying. As what is it, John Payne or Henry Clay said, I disagree with what you say, but I defend to the death your right to say it. Just pick the right spot. It's good. You're right. We got to do something about that. But is this the right venue? I just don't think he's fine.
Creates controversy, but it also creates conversation. We're talking about it. So maybe he... fulfilled his and accomplished his dream is to create this conversation.
Great.
Around the country.
And he could have held a press conference and accomplished the same goal.
Yeah, yeah. All right, we're going to take a break here and talk more to Peter Nazaridian. We'll kind of change topics here. 436 Mean TV Option 11. We'll talk about a very familiar topic to all of us. We'll talk about lying in just a moment.
Take a look at this.
Let's play.
This is too hip for you. I'll slow down.
Let's play.
Watch all your favorite classic game shows on Buzzer TV, KBBC Digital Channel 13.7.
The Justice Network is here. If you haven't tuned in, you're missing a great lineup of gripping stories of real crime, plus an unprecedented effort by viewers like you to play an active role in making your community safer. You can help support law enforcement by providing information that may lead to the apprehension of dangerous criminals or find a missing child. Great shows and your chance to fight crime, only on the Justice Network.
Back here on the program, Peter Nazaridian is here. Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead. Speak up loudly so we can hear you.
Hello. Good morning, Peter. Good morning, John. Great show. Good topic. Interesting topic. Kind of gets under my skin, actually. You know, I am a patriot, first of all. I think of myself as a patriot, and I think that everybody has a right to speak their mind in this country, and we shouldn't have to suppress that. But I also think that... you know, what Kaepernick's doing is somewhat maybe abusing the NFL's airwaves. He's got plenty of venues to do. You know, there's plenty of movie stars and plenty of sports figures that do activism outside of their, you know, athletic events when they're, playing with a team, as you mentioned. You know, I think one of the things that is probably the most upsetting and disturbing is that, you know, it's not about him, the protest or the message, but it's who the message is targeted at. When you disrespect the national anthem and you listen to the words of those anthem, this anthem's about the people that are putting their lives on the line, have put their lives on the line, will put their lives on the line for us, when the imminent threat comes. And, you know, as a family member who's, a lot of my family members have served in the military, my brother still serves today, I think it's very disrespectful of him, regardless of his freedom of speech. I think he's choosing the wrong venue, the wrong audience to target, and the wrong thing to oppose. And if he doesn't like what that anthem stands for, there's plenty of other countries that would be happy to take a pretty boy like him. So that's my message. And he sucks as a quarterback anyways. I never liked him when the Niners brought him on. So,
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much. Hey, I just want to clarify before you respond to that. You know, when we say that a quarterback is lousy or a player is lousy in the NFL, lousy in comparison to what? Comparing them to the other top echelon players, yeah. Okay, but compared to you and me, I don't think so. Could I do what Colin Kaepernick does? No. Could you?
No.
So when we say lousy, there has to be a comparison. Is he as good as Derek Carr? Probably not. Is he as good as, say, what's his name from the Patriots?
Brady.
Tom Brady. Of course not. So when you say lousy, you know, we use that term loosely. He's lousy next to Tom Brady. He's lousy next to some of the superstars of the league, but he's not that lousy because he's still in the NFL.
You got the Super Bowl, yeah.
Caller, hang on. Go ahead and comment what that last call
was. I sort of agree. As we have been saying, this is not the right venue. You know, that's a personal opinion, but yeah, there's lots of ways he could have done this, and movie stars, et cetera, don't shut down a movie set to make a stink. You do your job and do it on your own time, so there's something to be said for that. I agree.
Yeah. Caller, you're on the air with Peter.
Okay, I agree with John. He's there to play football. My point is, if you're there to make a point, do something about it. Is he doing anything, or is he just sitting there saying Black Lives Matter? If Black Lives Matter, do something about it. Don't just sit there and say something about it. Get in there and work with the kids. Do something. Work with the police. Is he doing anything? Does he have any camps, football camps? Is he working with the police out in the community? Or is he just sitting there saying, Black Lives Matter, I don't agree with the United States? Is he just flapping his gums?
Yeah, that's a good point. Well, he did actually agree last night during the news conference. He said he was going to donate his time to charity, and he was going to donate $1 million of his salary to those various organizations around the country that are fighting these racial injustices. So I guess he is now.
Well, let's see if that happens.
Yeah.
It's easy enough to say, I'll give my time. Well, let's see. Is he? How many hours does he actually give? The $1 million? Well, when you're making 19, one of those maybe is not such a big deal. I mean, it sounds like a lot of money to me, but, you know, when you got 18 more, maybe that's tax-wise, that's an advantage to him. I don't know. Let's see what he really does. Right now, it's all this.
Yeah, it really is. So, hey, let's change topics here. I want to talk about lying. And if you think over the course of time of how many of our big national public figures have lied, it really is astounding, my friends. Or is it? Is it shocking? Or is it kind? Does it just kind of roll off your back and you say, well, you know, it's business as usual around the country, whether it be with athletes or high-profile politicians? Some of the biggest names that have been caught lying, President Richard Nixon, as we all know by now. Now, many of you out there in the audience watching may not have been alive during the Nixon years, but yes, he did lie. So did President Bill Clinton. How about George H.W. Bush? Read my lips. No new taxes. Do you remember that back in the early 90s? George W. Bush, weapons of mass destruction. Hillary Clinton, Donald Trump. I don't know. How about lying Ted Cruz? All right, how about a couple of sports figures? Remember Pete Rose? I did not bet on baseball. Ryan Lochte seems to be one of the latest figures lying, but it seems to be a national trend now with everyone, or some people, I don't know. Take a look at this story, this piece about lying, and tell me that you won't break out laughing.
Mooney. All right, don't blame me for lying. I'm a product of my environment. These days, lying is all the rage. Everyone's doing it. Of course, lying is nothing new. We've been doing it since the beginning of time. Remember this oldie but goodie? Go ahead, eat the fruit. It's good for you. What could go wrong? But these days, it's not the frequency of the lies, but the quality of the lies that's alarming. In my day, when you lied, it was a good, solid American lie that stood up to intense scrutiny. But today's lies are flimsy, as if made in a third world country.
He took our money, he took my wallet.
Yep, this past week, US Olympic swimmer Ryan Lochte took the gold, silver, and bronze for the dumbest lie in the history of mankind, on an international stage nonetheless. And for what? To cover up breaking a bathroom door. Ryan, what are you, six? It's like you weren't even trying to lie. You call yourself an American? In this country, we just don't make lies like we used to.
Leaving Saddam Hussein in possession of weapons of mass destruction.
Remember how Colin told us there were weapons of mass destruction in Iraq? George ordered us to read his lips.
No new taxes.
Pete swore he never gambled.
I want you to listen to me. I'm going to say this again. I did not.
And Bill did not have sexual relations with that woman.
I had no knowledge whatever of the Watergate break-in before it occurred.
And who could forget the mother of all lies, Watergate? It took 2 years and millions of dollars to figure out this used car salesman was lying. Nowadays, it took less time to figure out Lochte was lying than it took him to swim the 200 backstroke. And this is the real concern. There's such a complete lack of respect for the truth and others, along with a belief that even if you get caught, there are no meaningful ramifications, that people are literally lying to our faces.
I did not email any classified material to anyone on my email.
ISIS is honoring President Obama. He is the founder of ISIS.
Look, I don't condone lying, but if you're going to do it, for God's sake, put in the effort. It's the only way we can make America great again. Now, if you excuse me, my wife, Mrs. Clooney, is waiting for me on our yacht in the south of France. What? She is. Of course, that depends on what your definition of is.
Yeah, darn it, Peter, what's the matter with you? You're going to lie to me. Put in some effort, for God's sake. Come on.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You got everybody laughing on that one. That was a good bit. Interesting concept with lying. Lying is we learn to lie about 5 or 6 years old. And it's usually to get out of trouble. You see a kid with a chocolate frosting around his mouth and says, "Did you eat that last piece of cake?" No. Because we want to get out of trouble. Now, the interesting thing about lying, though I have to tell my clients oftentimes, is lying is a higher order process. And that means that if your child learns to lie, this is a good thing. We love the fact that they can. We hate the fact that they do. Does that make sense?
Say that again.
We hate the fact that they, we love the fact that they can lie, because lying is a higher order process. We want our children to have a good brain power. If they're able to have complex concepts, they can learn to lie.
So we like that.
We like the fact that they can, because that says their brain is working. We hate the fact that they do, because, of course, that's not a very good thing. So, you know, that's an interesting concept there. Number two, why are they lying? With all these people you just mentioned there, they're all hoping to get out of, much like the kid with the frosting on his face, they want to get out of, out of jail free. Yeah. I didn't bet. I didn't have sex with that woman. I don't want any other stuff to follow me. Yeah. I thought I could get away with it.
Yeah, I knew nothing about Watergate.
I lied about it, but, I just don't want to get in trouble. So, really, they're all six.
Yeah.
That's what it is. In this kid down in the Olympics, I'm gonna get a national stage. I'm gonna make up a story, knowing what the internet is like, knowing that there's movie cameras everywhere, knowing that it's gonna get busted, and he just says it. Why? Because he, honest to God, thinks he's gonna get away with it. That entitlement mentality. And John, I see this in my office an awful lot. These people have an entitlement mentality. The idea that they should be able to lie and get away with it because they're special or they can. Well, obviously we can't.
Yeah, it's amazing. 436 MeTV, option 11. We'll come back and talk more about this topic of lying, habitual lying. What is that? I mean, we've heard the term, you're a born liar. What does that mean, you're a born liar? Does that mean that when you're actually born, there's some chemical in your brain that tells you, I have to be a liar? Is that what that means? 436 MeTV, option 11, back in a moment.
The following is another list of things you will not hear on MeTV programs. Man cave, baby bump, whatevs, double half calf mochaccino, faux hawk, redonkulous, totes adorbs, hella, holla, YOLO, cray cray, and MeTV is still Kardashian free. This is what you will hear on MeTV programs.
Bang!
Welcome, Denner. The Twilight Zone.
About bulls.
I object, Your Honor.
Mr. Grant.
I hear you right.
You heard me right.
MeTV. Thanks for listening.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the Samsung big screen we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Time for that upgrade to an HD, 3D, web-enabled Samsung TV. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
Back here on the program and talking about liars, what is a habitual liar?
Well, a habitual liar would be something we'd probably call pathological lying. That okay. means that there seems to be something ingrained in their personality where they just want to fool people. Some people have that idea, they just want to get away with stuff. And we all have a little bit of that. I can remember as a young man once my dad asking me where I was going, you know, to a friend's house. I said, I'm going to Bob's house. And it turns out I was going to Bill's house. And going to Bill's house would have been fine. But I just wanted to get away with it. I wanted to fool him because he was the kind of guy that you just, you know, you couldn't fool. And there was a great deal of pleasure in being able to pull one over. Minor though it was, I found myself doing it, looking back on it, I think, I just wanted to get away with it to see if I could. So there's a certain, does that make me a pathological liar? No, hopefully not. But
what is a pathological liar in a technical, from a technical standpoint?
Someone who is manipulative to the point where everything becomes a lie to be self-serving. Pathological. Even when they don't have to lie, they will, and they'll lie about almost everything, to be in control, to have power, to get away with things. It's the pathological need to be okay and fool everybody. It's the property of a sociopath.
Yeah. What do you do when your kids lie to you?
Well, it depends on the situation. Like I said, kids learn to lie because they want to get out of trouble. So of course, can you expect your kid to lie? Sure. Especially if they did something, broke the vase or the window or whatever it was, they're going to, I didn't do it. Well, he was the one. We all try to get away with it. What you can do with your children is teach them to take responsibility. You know, the old story of George Washington and the cherry tree. I cannot tell a lie. I cut down the tree. Well, okay, we won't punish you because you told the truth. As we think, it didn't really happen, but it makes a great story. If you just tell the truth, you won't have huge consequences. I wish people would explain that to the kids more. You might remember, John, you've been here a while, the story of Robert Lukey. Do you remember this story years ago with the young man in the parking lot who confronted on New Year's Eve and shot somebody and killed him?
Hang on, caller.
For their presence. And then the mother said he was here at home, he didn't do it. Basically just lied completely to get him out of trouble when he shot somebody. And and looked at the press like they were crazy. You know, this is what a mother does. You defend your son. You don't do the right thing, you defend him.
Caller, you're there on the air with Peter. Okay. Call back, caller, if whoever called in, 436-ME-TV, option 11. When you hear the voice mail, you just hit option 11. Sorry about that. I don't know why we didn't connect there, but it's an easy thing to do is to call back. And so let's put up some of these full screens that we put together here. And we've heard the term, the truth hurts, all right? The truth does hurt. All right. What are we looking at here? The truth hurts. What are you thinking about? You know, I think whenever I catch somebody lying to me, or whenever I catch my kids lying, I think that's the first thing that comes out of my mouth. What are you thinking about? What are you thinking? I even ask myself that sometimes, to be honest with you.
And, well, the simple answer to that one is I want to get out of trouble. I want to avoid consequences. So chances are I don't want to be blamed for doing this. And the moral question is, can I accept responsibility even though I don't want to?
Right. Let's get out of this for a moment, take this call. We'll come right back to it. Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
How do I get my kids to stop lying to me?
Wow, there's sweet and simple. A couple of ways. Number one, this is true for any parent at any time. The single best way in the world to affect your children is to model. Be the person you want them to be. Always tell the truth. So number one, and not specifically this caller, but generally, do you always tell the truth? Are you someone who, you know, you say something and the kids say, well, Dad, that's not true. You know, well, yeah, I know, but I said it for this reason. If you're modeling behavior that, you know, white lies or fibs, then the kids learn that that's okay. So where do children learn to lie? Because it's part of that process, but because they see it happening around them, even the quote-unquote white lies. So best way you can do it is always be honest yourself and bring it out. You know, that was a tough thing to say, but that was the right thing to do. I have to take consequences. By showing how to take and accept consequences and not lying about it is the best single way in the world to get your kids to stop.
Okay, let's put up that full screen again, pick it up where we left off. And so does this relate to relationships? Is this what we're looking at? Is this boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, and wife? Because what we're looking at here, are you attracted to him or her? Did you miss me? Where were you? Where are you right now? Where are you? Is this a relationship thing we're talking about here?
Well, in many ways, there's an old joke in our business that, you know, men lie because women give them crap about it. I'm not going to tell you I had lunch with my secretary, you'll give me crap. I'm not going to tell you I had two beers on the way home, you'll give me crap. I'm not going to tell you I'm going to my buddy's house to fix his car, you'll give me crap. So men lie, so, you know, to get away with stuff. It's the same situation. I'm trying to get away with it. It's a mommy thing. Is it good? No, of course not. But this is what people do because I don't want consequences. Oh, I'll just sit here and listen to her yap at me, and this is going to be difficult. I won't do it. Now, all they're doing is postponing it, obviously. But yes, it's a very typical relationship ploy.
Yeah, we'll change the screen now and pick it up. Why didn't you answer the phone, Peter? Where were you?
Yeah.
Why are you so quiet? Is there anything wrong? Have you ever thought about being with someone else?
Now, these are interesting questions because in reality, you know, how are you supposed to answer that? Why didn't you answer the phone? Why didn't I answer the phone? Because I didn't want to talk to you, because I thought I'd get in trouble. Because if you answer honestly, you're not going to like that answer. So they're asking a question to which they want a magical answer. What can I tell you where you're going to go, oh, is that why you didn't answer the phone? Oh, okay, that's fine. What can you possibly say where that's going to be the response? So what it is basically saying, I'm angry at you that you did this thing. I'm making a question out of it, but it's really a statement. Why are you so quiet? How am I supposed to answer that? Because I don't feel like being noisy? That's not going to be a very satisfying answer. Is there anything wrong? Depending on how if you say it, is there anything wrong? Shoot, I don't want to say a darn thing now with that tone of voice. Or if you're saying, honey, is there anything wrong? Maybe I'll be more encouraged. So the tone has an awful lot to do with it. Have you ever thought about being with somebody else? We've all thought about being with somebody else.
I mean, that's
of course. Of course. That's a human nature thing. You look, oh, look at that person. Oh, we think about it? Sure. We're going to do it? No. But if the question is, have you thought about it? We've all thought about it. But if you answer that honestly and the person's insecure, you're going to catch heck for it. So, you know, asking those kinds of questions and expecting the honest answer, as they said in, what is it, A Few Good Men, you can't handle the truth. Sometimes you don't really want to hear it.
Most people can't handle the truth. I'd rather hear the truth.
Yes. Sure.
Wouldn't you?
Sure.
Absolutely. If it hurts.
Even if it hurts. At least now we're dealing with the issue.
At least now it's on the table. I can deal with it and move on.
Right.
Am I right?
Whatever it is, we can deal with it. Because if you lie, eventually we've got to go through all the lie, and then we get to the truth, which now makes it more complicated and difficult. So keep it simple. Tell the truth to begin with. Usually it goes away much faster.
Keep it simple. Just tell a simple lie.
I didn't eat the cake.
So why do people lie? Is it basically, like you said, to try to get out of trouble?
Yeah.
That's all it is?
Yeah. That's
it's as simple as that?
It is as simple as that, unless it's pathological, in which case it's about power and control. It's not something, you know, avoiding trouble may be a collateral benefit, but I want to manipulate you. I want you to think I'm doing this instead of that.
So what do you want power and control over? A person?
Other people, sure. Situations, absolutely. Absolutely.
Hmm.
Power and control, that's how we, as kids, you know, trying to make do things, we're all looking for power and control in lives in which we have none. So,
all right, how do you tell if someone is lying?
That's a very difficult and complicated situation, because some people are so good at lying that you really can't tell. And during the break, Carrie asked me, you know, can I tell if people are lying? Sometimes.
Okay, wait a second. Let's break this down. How can you tell? Are you looking directly into their eyes? Can you tell there? Or is it the lack of eye contact? Or what is it?
Sometimes it's a lack of eye contact. Sometimes it's too much detail.
Oh, we have a caller here.
Sometimes it's, you know.
Hang on, caller.
I won't go into it too much here, but if you look up and to the right as opposed to up and to the left, it tells you what you're thinking. Down to the right, down to the left. These are all significant. You know, when people make those gestures, you can tell where they're going in their mind. So sometimes there are some very specific ways to tell.
Go ahead, caller. You're on the air with Peter.
Yes, Peter.
Yes.
This is Thomas. Listen, lying and hiding go together. You cannot lie and not hide, and you can't hide and not lie. So they go together, and our dignity in this country has gone downhill since way back, and it's getting worse.
Well, there's a lot to what you say, and I will tell you that in my practice, I see an awful lot of what I call this entitlement mentality. And the entitlement mentality says, among other things, not I should have anything I want, to go any place I want, to be with anybody I want. I should also get away with anything I want. And because high-profile people do get away with lying sometimes, we saw that clip, we feel, well, why can't we do that too? But the hiding and lying, yeah, I think those two things do go together. And walking in the sunshine, as they say, is the best way in the world to, you know, with relationships and everything else. Just be totally honest. What they say, you know, if you never lie, you never have to remember anything.
Yeah, that's the old adage, right?
It makes it nice, yeah.
All right, 436-ME-TV, option 11 if you want to call in. You get the recording, just hit option 11. We'll get you right in. Few minutes remaining here on the program.
Sports is now on KVHF 4.3.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the Samsung big screen we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Time for that upgrade to an HD, 3D, web-enabled Samsung TV. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
We're back here on the program. So break down the, let's take a call here first. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air with Peter.
I want to know what to do if someone's so brutally honest that it's cruel.
Ooh, that's a great one.
That's a great question, because we brutally honest is not the same as not lying. For example, God, John, you look horrible in orange. Well, that may be my truth that you don't look good in orange, but is that a universal truth? Is that, you know, is that actually accurate? It's only my perception. So brutally honest sometimes is not the same as telling the truth. Brutally honest sometimes covers up. I can be insulting. I can be critical. I can be judgmental. Hey, I'm just telling the truth. I'm just being honest. So it comes across, you know, well, is that being honest or is that just your opinion? There's a difference between what's factual, actual, and what's my opinion. So,
but there's a fine line between the two.
Brutal honesty. I mean, would I prefer to have somebody be, well, brutally honest? That's a hard word. Be absolutely honest, completely honest. I'd rather go that way. Yeah, I would.
Is
absolutely.
Is the caller still there? Caller's gone.
Okay.
So
be careful. Brutal honesty is sometimes a way of hiding being critical and being judgmental and just saying, I'm just being honest. I get away with it. Yeah.
But in getting back to lying, you're talking about your clientele. By the way, give your phone number out. The name of your business is For Head Care, right?
Yeah, no, that's my email. It's Fig Garden Counseling Center. And my number,
Fig Garden, that's right.
Yeah,
that's
Fig Garden Counseling Center. And it's 252-9700. Again, 252-9700.
Yeah, so make an appointment. Go in if you have any issues that you want to talk to Peter about. So when you look at somebody, what, again, are the signs? You went through them really fast, and I missed half of them. So how can you tell?
I wasn't specific.
Looking to the left, looking to the right?
Yeah, people who, generally speaking, if you're looking up to the right or up to the left, down to the right or down to the left, sometimes tells us whether you're lying and what it's about. I'm not going to go into the specifics of it, but that's one of the ways. Also, too much detail. Somebody who spins the yarn, where were you? Well, I was in traffic, and you should have seen this dog ran across, and the fireman came, and this guy in a red car came out with a fire extinguisher. Too many details. Generally speaking, when there's too many details, it's usually not accurate. But the most things people happen, I don't know, I was just jammed up. I was sitting there for 20 minutes. That would be honest. So too many details. I had that in a client years ago, was talking about how he lived with his mom and how these people came and broke into the house and took their money and everything else, and just this incredible detail. I could tell he was lying. He was on drugs and he was stealing, but he wanted to blame somebody else. Too much detail gave him away. So there are ways.
Yeah, but you see it all the time with What type of clientele are they? Does it run the gamut?
Yeah, it really
young,
does.
Old?
Yeah, and every walk of life. I mean, here the clip you showed are all people who are intelligent, highly placed, good,
successful,
make good incomes. So it doesn't have to do with that sort of thing. Sometimes those people want power and control the most, so they lie the most to get their way. There are other people, oddly enough, the most simple people who tell the truth because it just seems so much easier. They don't want to spin the yarn. Oddly enough, it's probably the more intelligent a person is, the more likely they are to lie.
Well, have you ever sat down with a client and you just openly said to the client, why are you lying to me?
Yeah.
You have?
Sure.
And the response?
Generally speaking, the direct approach works pretty well. Sometimes once or twice I've had somebody get so offended they couldn't maintain the lie, they just got up and walked out. They just couldn't take it.
Really?
Yeah.
You've had somebody walk out?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they were so invested in maintaining the facade, the charade, that they didn't want to tell the truth. Well, therapy doesn't work if you don't tell the truth.
Caller, go ahead. You're on the air with Peter Nazaridian.
Hello, I wanted to make a comment to the doctor. Can I make it?
Yeah, sure.
Huh?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, there's only three reasons a person lies. One is to get something they don't have coming, or to avoid. Yeah, to get something they don't have coming.
You need to turn the sound down on your TV, sir.
And the other one is to avoid something they do have coming.
Okay, that's it, Marcus. Thank you. Okay, just a little footnote here before you answer that. When you do call in, you must mute the sound on your television set or turn that sound down, because as you heard, that caller there was talking on the phone and then listening to his answer on the TV set. Can't do that because then we get feedback. But we got the gist of it. And you know what? The caller had good intentions.
Yeah.
Caller had great intentions.
And what we did here was absolutely true. You know, you're trying to get away with something. You want something you shouldn't have. You're trying to get over on somebody, avoid consequences. Yeah, these are all typical ways to fib. Oh, yeah, my dog ate. What is the dog ate my homework? I mean, we all sort of learned that one because we don't want to be in trouble at school. So it's to avoid consequences. And yet we all know that if you lie to avoid consequences and it comes out, and I find that the truth always comes out, then the consequences are twice as bad.
So let me get this straight now. People who go to therapy will not help them if they are lying.
Yeah.
If they are lying.
Yeah.
Because?
The therapy is about making honest changes. If something's not working in your life, let's do something different. It's not, you know, let me have a better story. That's not the point of it. The point is to actually get a healthier relationship or a healthier interaction or a healthier sense of who you are. Well, you can't do that if you're not dealing with the truth. So you have to be honest with yourself. You have to be honest with your therapist. Yeah, but then they won't like me. That's one of the biggest things. If I tell you the truth, you're going to think, oh, this person, oh, I don't like them. They do terrible things. Actually, most of us as therapists, we don't judge. We have our own issues to begin with, number one, so we're not
quickly,
in
have you ever gone along with one of your clients, just gone along with the lie just to keep the peace, or no?
If I didn't know they were lying, yes, because I didn't know. Obviously,
if you know they're lying, then you don't go along with it.
Then I'll confront them. Okay, why are you fibbing to me right now? Why is that important to you? I'll just confront them.
Yeah. Hey, Peter, we're going to see you, I think, later this month, and
yep.
We'll come back. We'll have another great topic to talk. There's always something to talk about, I guarantee
always
you.
Something.
Oh, yeah. We like to stir it up a little bit here. Peter Nazaridian, have a
My
good
pleasure.
Holiday weekend. Have a safe weekend.
Thanks, everybody. Have a great holiday weekend.
All right. Back here on Monday live for Labor Day with Doug Begum. Have a good one and see you then.
event, please consider MeTV Fresno for your next campaign. MeTV reaches over 100,000 of your potential customers in the Fresno area every single week. Plus, you can rest assured that your commercial is running in the greatest family-friendly programs of all time. MeTV Fresno delivers a strong, loyal audience ready to buy, and your campaign will cost a fraction of what you're paying for your advertising now. Call me today to find out how affordable MeTV is at 905-1925.
Dare. It means the first refrigerator. It means a history of innovations that help make your home life better. And now we introduce the new Frigidaire French door refrigerator with over 100 ways to organize for maximum flexibility. Built with adjustable flip-up and slide-under shelving and stackable crisper drawers, it's the refrigerator that flexes to fit it all, no matter what your day will bring. Frigidaire, over 90 years of legendary innovation.
See the full line of Frigidaire appliances at Ventura TV Electronics and Appliances.